Hey, Pentax Tips here. We have a high ISO test for you today with the K-3 Mark III and the K-70. I'll be doing the image acquisition.
And I'll be taking a look at the results in post. See you there.
So let's start with the K-3 Mark III.
I metered my scene for the maximum ISO on the K-3 Mark III, and that gave me a shutter speed so I don't blow out my images with the max shutter speed of 1/8,000th of a second. And that gave me an aperture of f7.1. I'll be shooting DNGs to a single card slot. I'm going to turn off the slow shutter and high ISO noise reduction. I want to see what the raw sensor output can produce. I'm also not using any dynamic range correction or anything that might alter the image. Yeah, I have a 2-second timer to reduce any shake that I might produce, and let's get set up here with my ISO and begin the test. I've decided to manually move my shutter speed to try and make everything as equal as possible between the two cameras. Here we go. Now we'll try out the K-70. Now with the K-70, I'll double check that I have no noise reduction or dynamic range settings, and it looks like I'm overexposed by about 1/3 of a stop compared to the K-3 Mark III. I'll start by using the same base shutter as the K-3 Mark III, and we'll see where we get from there. Great, now that we're complete, we'll compare these results in post.
Here we are in post. I'm going to rip through these with the K-3 Mark III on the left and the K-70 on the right. Starting with base ISO 100, right off the bat, you can tell that the K-70 is indeed about 1/3 of a stop overexposed, but that's pretty darn close. I'm going to use this old VHS logo as a reference point throughout my test. Both images look great at ISO 100 with no noticeable grain. ISO 200 also looks great with no real noticeable differences. I do love the color saturation on the K-3 Mark III. ISO 400 looks clean in both images. ISO 800 is looking good. There's still no real eye-catching noise issues. At ISO 1600, the K-3 still looks pretty clean, while the K-70 has a little bit of noise in the shadows. ISO 3200, you can notice a very little bit of noise in the K-3 Mark III shadows, but this still looks entirely usable. The K-70 is noisy throughout the image. You can notice the noise is just starting to affect the exposure. It looks like noise reduction tools would start being needed here. At ISO 6400, the K-3 has some noticeable noise throughout the image, but it looks easily workable with a noise reduction tool. For the K-70, you'll definitely want to use noise reduction to clean up the shadows. ISO 12800. Here the K-3 Mark III looks like it would need a noise reduction tool to tidy up the shadows. However, the exposure and colors are still well maintained. The K-70 exposure is noticeably noisy and could still probably be salvageable with the noise reduction tool. Pretty impressive, actually. At ISO 25600, the K-70 could still probably be used without a crop and on small formats, but zoomed in, we can definitely notice the snowstorm coming in for the K-70 with noticeable sharpness reduction. The K-3 Mark III looks like it could be salvageable with noise reduction and colors are well maintained. At ISO 51200, we can begin seeing noise in the zoomed out K-70 image, but zoomed in, you can start noticing color noise and the blizzard is picking up. However, this is still pretty impressive and could maybe be salvaged with a good noise reduction tool. At ISO 102400, the color noise is noticeable zoomed out on the K-70, while the K-3 Mark III is still pretty tidy. Zoomed in, the K-70 exposure is really being affected by noise and sharpness is strongly dissipating. Zoomed in, the K-3 Mark III is just beginning to have a touch of color noise and sharpness is just beginning to take a hit. It would need a strong dose of noise reduction, but perhaps salvageable for an emergency. And that tops out the K-70. I'll present the rest of the K-3 Mark III ISO for interest as well. At ISO 204,800, the color noise is noticeable zoomed out and definitely noticeable zoomed in. The blizzard has arrived for the K-3 Mark III. At ISO 409,600, We see the exposure really struggling with the noise, and the colors are pretty messy. There's no real detail left. ISO 812,200 shows substantial exposure and color noise issues zoomed out, and zoomed in is nearly a complete whiteout. Lastly, ISO 1,600,000 is barely identifiable zoomed out, and zoomed in is just indiscernible noise. But what about that third stop exposure issue? I'm going to jump to the develop module and sync a third extra exposure to the K3 Mark III images and compare those results. I'm going to start at ISO 1600. Exposure is definitely better matched. Maybe I see a little bit of noise in the shadows for both images. ISO 3200 with corrected exposure shows perhaps a slight edge to the K3 Mark III. There is an ever so slight bit of noise across both images. ISO 6400 shows the K3 Mark III really controlling exposure well, but the K70 does begin to show some exposure issues in the shadows. For ISO 12800, both images look a bit noisy, the K70's noise looks a little bit chunkier, and I feel the K3 Mark III holds its saturation and exposure better than the K70. Still both usable zoomed out. At ISO 25600, I can start seeing color noise on the K70 zoomed out, and it's definitely more noticeable zoomed in. No noticeable color noise from the K3 Mark III. It would be salvageable with noise reduction, and the K3 Mark III is definitely holding its exposure and saturation well. Meanwhile, the K70 is feeling the snowstorm. For ISO 51200, the snowstorm is just starting to be noticeable for the K3 Mark III, with a touch of color noise zoomed in. The K70 shows noise while zoomed out, and the shadows are turning to a bit of mush zoomed in. At ISO 102,400, while the K70 is in the thick of the snowstorm, the K3 is performing pretty impressively, with more retained saturation and retained exposure. However, there is color noise now too, and the sharpness is taking a hit. And there we have it! We've compared our available ISOs. If you like this content and want to see more like it, please remember to like and subscribe. Thanks!